We have about 150 to 200 million persons coming on broadband. We have 950 million registered mobile users in a country of 1.2 billion. Active users would be 640 million. 640 million is just about half of India. But every sweeper, every person, every serviceman seems to be carrying on mobile, and they invariably get more calls than I ever do. Because whenever I ask them for a work, the phone is ringing. I don't know whether they're doing in horse trading or tips or whatever. I don't know what they do, but they seem to get... I mean, I also get my call. Mine one is on silent mode, but you find the less important you thought the band was, its phone is ringing all the time. They come up with all sorts of atrocious things. Now, 950 million mobile sets, handsets, bring it down to 640, would be coming up back to about 800, forward to 800 active mobile sets in the next 2 years. Tablet, I mean, I keep getting muddled because to me, tablet still means the pill that you pop. But tablet, of course, means something different. Tablet prices have crashed in India, the land of copycats. You don't need to invent anything. All you need is to find how the other guy made it and make it cheaper. Jugaad technology. Well, soul of India. So, on this, you find tablet prices crashing. I just attended and presided over the International Broadcasting Union meeting. And when I mentioned $50, $35, they whistled. I said, yeah, we can do it. The basics are there. Because the Indian knows that you won't be using so many things. My first arrival in Delhi from Calcutta, 1984, freezing climate and no heater along. In comes a Sardar who does a lot of beating and then puts a rod in front of the blower of, and 10 minutes the air conditioner becomes a heater. Now, Loji, Parchi sign karo, bas ho gaye. And the ingenuity is mind-boggling. So with the tablet prices crashing and the mobiles becoming more frequent, what are we heading for? The first revolution in computing in India took place before many of our senior friends' eyes. I have seen the first computer in Jadavpur University. It's about the size of the stage with so many Godrej Almiras. And it would be processing less than half of what my mobile can do. Then,
Honeywell computer.
Then came the that punch card driven technologies, and the Indian Jugaad mind used the waste punch card for bus tickets. Okay. We've seen that. And then let us travel fast. 85, 86, the PC comes. The PC becomes the most decorated furniture item in the room because none of us know how to use it. Come along with it comes a floppy, which is actually like a disk. You put it in, you finish the Dale's papers, it goes on like an ET from another world, dips, beeps, makes all sorts of squeaks. You have your toast, have your breakfast, and then it comes on DOS. What was DOS? Data operating systems. Disk operating systems. And then slowly the computer becomes personal and things like that, and the PC becomes more often this, it becomes an addiction. All of us stop using, I mean, I'm talking to my male friends, they look at the emails more than they look at females, and it goes on like that. It becomes an addiction. And then we suddenly find, again, we have come to a chomohani, a chalk where we're all getting lost. Giving you a prognosis, almost like Nostradamus, that the way we are heading is to the mobile generation. Our generation was upwardly mobile, this generation is going to be mobile. That way. Our communication, if any, can hardly be on a face-to-face basis. That becomes a luxury. On a non-animated, non-active basis, that also becomes a thing. It could actually be all on PowerPoints. It's once you get in and instead of reading and using the chalk again and again, it's getting to be so. It's all possible, I can see it. And coming back, I will still mention the three mantras of communication. That would remain valid irrespective of whether we take the village road, the district road, the medium road, the highway or the superway. It's going to be text, subtext and context. Thank you very much.